Hey, I got a confession. Been losing all momentum.
It is Graham here, living the dream in October 2021 at the fantastic Sandals Grand Antigua. As you can see in the caption of this first video in our Antigua 21 adventure, this is a pure trip report. It's a trip report aboard Virgin Atlantic Airways in a Boeing 787-9 from London Heathrow to Antigua.
Join Fiona and I on Friday, the 1st of October 2021, in seats 27E and F on board a brand new British Airways Airbus A320neo, turning final to London Heathrow Airport runway 27 left, overhead the London XL Centre, London City Airport and the O2 Arena, before lining up overhead the City of London. And as you can see, it was a beautiful afternoon as we made our approach to London Heathrow International Airport. This is the first time I'd been to London Heathrow in over 2 years, and as a self-confessed avgy, it was really sad to see that the British Airways Boeing 747-400s that would usually be lining up at the B and C gates have all been replaced by these wide-body twins, of course Boeing 777s and 787s. A sad reality where COVID has left British Airways retiring the old quad jets quite a few years ahead of plan. I'll give British Airways their due. The deplaning process was very smooth, extremely well organised, and funny enough, the passengers all seemed to adhere to the rules to deplane safely due to the COVID pandemic, leaving Fiona and I to head in to T5 and collect our bags because we were staying overnight at the Premier Inn at London Heathrow, Terminal 5, funny enough. But before that, no stay at the Premier Inn would be complete without cocktails and crisps from M&S Simply Food at the airport before heading out to the bus pickup point, which quite frankly was a complete disaster. The airport hotel transfer buses are supposed to pick you up every 30 minutes outside the front of the terminal, but after well over an hour of hanging around and waiting in the cold, Fiona and I gave up and got in a taxi at the cost of £20. And of course, a black mark against Heathrow, because at Gatwick, the Premier Inn is connected to the North Terminal and it's only a few minutes walk from arrivals. But of course, arriving in Premier Inn, you know exactly what you're getting with the room. For £25, yes, you heard me right, £25. We got a basic but very comfortable room, of course, with that king-size Hypnos bed. A small but extremely clean and functional bathroom with an excellent power shower. But in reality, what else do you need on a one-night layover between flights? I love Premier Inns, and for £25, you can't go wrong. Add a meal and breakfast deal, and you really are set for less than £100.
Cheers. Here's to a great night. Who does that? Dennis Bunnock. Good morning from the Premier Inn at London Heathrow, Terminal 5 on, what day is it?
Saturday.
The 2nd of October 2021. And what's special about the 2nd of October? It's Fiona's birthday. So, where are we going for your birthday?
Antigua.
And are we going on British Airways this year?
No, I'm going to be a virgin traveller.
You'll be a virgin?
I will be a virgin.
When were you last a virgin?
That's a
very, very, very long time ago. So for the first time on Living the Dream, we're going on Virgin. So next up, London Heathrow, Terminal 3, and the clubhouse for champagne, I think, to celebrate Fiona's birthday. I'm going to Antigua. Just like the night before, the very unreliable airport hotel transfer buses let us down again. So Fiona and I decided, once again, to take a taxi over
to Terminal 3 at London Heathrow. The taxi dropped us off at the dedicated upper-class check-in terminal at T3, which had Fiona and I through security and into duty-free in a matter of only a few minutes, which allowed my gorgeous wife plenty of time for some retail therapy before we made our way to the Virgin Atlantic Clubhouse. So between Virgin's dedicated terminal for checking in, and as you'll see in a few seconds, the incredible, the awesome, the fantastic Virgin business class lounge that they call the Clubhouse, for Fiona and I, it was a massive thumbs up to Virgin ahead of British Airways, which is our usual mode of transport across the Atlantic to Sandals. And finding a seat with a view, the first order of the day was, of course, that first glass of champagne. The menu in the clubhouse was incredible, it was fantastic, but sadly Fiona and I had already had breakfast at the Premier Inn. So while the Eggs Benedict looked incredibly inviting, Fiona and I wanted to save ourselves for the onboard service. And far too soon, the flight was boarding, so it was time for the long walk through the corridors of Terminal 3 to our aircraft, which today would be a Boeing 787-9 Dreamliner, which was actually an aircraft change because we had been due to fly on board an Airbus A330-300 on the service between London Heathrow and Antigua this morning. But of course, with the Boeing Dreamliner being my favourite aircraft to travel on, I certainly wasn't disappointed. I last walked these corridors of Heathrow's Terminal 3 less than 2 years ago, when catching an American Airlines service between London Heathrow, of course, and Dallas-Fort Worth. Fiona and I did comment how fantastic it was to see London Heathrow so busy again, especially after last year's transit through Gatwick en route between London and St. Lucia. What a difference a year has made throughout this terrible pandemic. With vaccinations comes open borders and the ability for us all to travel again. So Fiona and I really didn't mind the fact that our aircraft was parked at probably the most furthest away gate at T3. So we lined up at the dedicated upper class lane where we would be directed to board the aircraft right away. It's always a great feeling to be able to turn left when you board the aircraft. And on today's ride across to Antigua, Fiona and I would be sitting in seats 1A and 2A. Of course, something we wouldn't have been doing on board British Airways unless we'd splashed out for first class. I'm still not sure about the seat design or business class layout on board Virgin Atlantic. However, despite the poor storage, each seat did have direct aisle access. However, it wasn't great for a couple like Fiona and I. And for those of you who've watched my trip reports in the past on board British Airways Club World, you all know that I love the 20-year-old yin-yang seat configuration where facing backwards I can talk to my wife during the journey across the Atlantic. Anyway, it was time for pushback and taxi to runway 09 right at London Heathrow. And as you can see, it was a pretty manky day when we started our trip across to the Caribbean, where Fiona and I were looking forward to 2 weeks in the sun. that was us finally airborne on the 7-hour, 40-minute flight, westbound across the Atlantic to Antigua. I must admit, I've never got to grips with these electronic window shades on board the Dreamliner. The cabin crew and the overall service in upper class was actually very good. The beer was cold, but I have to admit that's where it really ended, because the main meal lunch service was actually pretty poor. The choices weren't great, and unlike British Airways, you're unable to pre-book your meal. So with the airline running out of my choice, I was left ordering chicken tikka masala from the economy menu. And while the awesome cabin crew on board Virgin Atlantic's upper class did replate my meal, it didn't stop it being dry and pretty unexciting. So when it comes to onboard food during normal times, I'm going to give it to British Airways. However, Fiona was very taken by the little salt and pepper shakers that Virgin had in upper class, leaving Fiona and I to sit back, relax, and enjoy the Virgin hospitality on the service across the Atlantic. An hour and a half before landing in Antigua, afternoon tea included a very nice chicken burger and crisps, or chips to you Americans. So hands down to Virgin Atlantic, the afternoon tea service is definitely much better than those finger sandwiches you get aboard British Airways in the Club World cabin. With the afternoon tea service complete, we were on initial descent towards Antigua and VC Bird International Airport. So how am I going to sum up Virgin Atlantic upper class against British Airways Club World? Without a doubt, the Virgin Atlantic ground service at London Heathrow is miles better than British Airways. But I'm just not sure that Virgin can compete with British Airways in the air. They both generally have great cabin crew, but I just think that this seating configuration on board Virgin lets them down slightly, and certainly the food wasn't great. Back to deplaning here at VC Bird International Airport in Antigua, it's probably time to tell you about the arrival process during this latter stages, or what we hope is the latter stages of the COVID-19 pandemic. When we arrived in Antigua on the 2nd of October 2021, we were required to produce a negative COVID test, which you could see in the previous video we completed 4 days before travel. All arriving passengers into Antigua also had to produce proof of receiving at least one vaccine injection. Fiona and I were double vaccinated, so that was no problem. So at this point in the arrival process, we were being held at the top of the stairs, where the airport authorities were holding passengers in batches before releasing us to go downstairs to the first check, which of course was the medical checkpoint where our temperatures were taken and where our negative PCR tests were validated, along with our vaccine certificates. However, what I will say is the organisation here in Antigua was very good, and the medical checks only added about 10 minutes to the arrival process, and after that it was straight through to immigration, which of course I didn't film, picking this trip report back up at the baggage reclaim belts. But all in all, from stepping off the aircraft to picking up our cases from the baggage reclaim belt took less than 30 minutes, leaving Fiona and I to pass through the customs checks before heading through arrivals, heading in the direction of the exit doors and of course the sandals kiosk. So it is at this point I'm going to bring this video to a close, and in the next video I'll cover the free sandals airport transfer bus service. So until then, thank you very much for watching, and if you want to continue to follow Fiona and I on our Antigua 21 adventure, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.